strength
and stiffness. Hello, everybody. I am Nick, the Naval Architect. Today, we're going to talk about the design of structural foundations, strength and stiffness. The balance between these two qualities forms the basis for any structural foundation. The general hull structure of a ship focuses on distributed pressures, like the hydrostatic pressure of the ocean. But our ships also include many concentrated loads, like the pedestal for a crane or the main engine. The art of foundation design finds an efficient arrangement to redistribute these concentrated loads into the general ship structure. Today, I'm going to review the basic strategies for foundation design. The word foundation applies to nearly every piece of deck reinforcement on a ship. Everything from that little stanchion up to the 5,000 metric ton construction crane. But none of the smaller foundations require any intensive design effort. Don't go breaking your design budget doing intensive FEA of a handrail. For those small things, we just apply an extra strong structure and don't worry about the excess weight of that foundation. It only adds a few extra pounds of weight. On commercial ships, the paint alone will weigh more than your little foundations. But with larger loads, like a deck crane, an inefficient foundation can result in hundreds of tons of extra structure. That's extra steel that we need to pay for, extra labor to assemble it, extra cost that simply was not necessary. Previous to finite element analysis, we intentionally limited our foundations to simpler arrangements that were safely analyzed with first principles and hand calculations. We were limited by the math at the time. But this is the modern world. Thanks to the widespread use of FEA, we now have the freedom to identify the high stress spots, get creative, build structures that follow the physics. End result? Efficient foundations. Now I know efficiency doesn't seem that important until you consider the cost implications. Sure, lighter structures require less fuel, but they also mean large savings for the shipyard. Take a look at the table on your screen. This shows the estimated costs for three different foundation designs. When we account for the cost of fabrication, cost savings quickly add up. That last foundation was estimated at $61,000 less. Think of what you could do with that extra cash. I've got a whole wish list. But even better, those savings come relatively cheap. The table on your screen compares the cost savings against the engineering effort required to achieve them. In this sense, engineers are cheap. Foundation number three showed a return on investment of over 1,000%. Imagine getting a 10-to-1 return on your investments. When it comes to structural foundations, engineering optimization is a good bet for savings. Enough generalities. Let's give a specific example. Most foundations include some type of a dense structure joining to a deck on the ship. For the remainder of this article, I'm going to work with a single example, the foundation for a fictional pedestal crane that's attached to a barge. The pedestal imparts a large bending moment and a large downward force. So how do we design a foundation for this? The first step is we need to understand how this pedestal imparts stresses to the deck. We design our foundations based upon the stresses on the physics, not geometry. So we might think that a uniform pedestal that's one giant tube also means a uniform load distribution. Nope. The bending of that pedestal concentrates the stresses onto two sides. The figure on your screen shows just the regions of high stress. Looking at it in this sense, we see that the sides of the pedestal are barely doing anything. Rather than a round tube, our pedestal is behaving as if it has the top and bottom flanges of an I-beam. And this is why I said we design foundations based upon the stresses, not the geometry. So we now understand the problem. We need to take these two concentrated loads from either side of the pedestal and redistribute them into the ship structure. But the ship's structure was built for stresses that generally run horizontally along the deck and the bottom shell. So in addition to distributing these concentrated loads, our foundation also needs to change the direction of our loads from vertical to horizontal. If our pedestal is behaving like an I-beam, why not use an I-beam? Well, that's the second challenge of foundation design. The direction of our loads changes. The figure on your screen shows the stress patterns for only one orientation of the crane. As the crane rotates, so does the stress pattern. And that is why we use a circular pedestal, so that it can accept loads from any direction. That also means our foundation needs to accept loads from any direction. So that's quite a few requirements, and it's no doubt that is a challenge. So let's let the fun begin. The keys to a good foundation are strength and stiffness. We want a strong structure that maintains similar stiffness as it distributes the stresses. Similar stiffness is a key word here. Not all parts of the structure should be equally stiff. We need to recognize the natural stress paths and place our stiff structure along those stress paths. FEA certainly helps with seeing the stress paths. Look for the highly stressed regions, but FEA only shows results for the structure that you specify. It doesn't find solutions, it tests solutions that you already think about. It takes experience and a little experimentation to see past your current structure and find where the stresses want to go. Now, there's no shortcut here. The physics behind this strategy requires background knowledge on stress patterns, interaction between the geometry, strain, material stiffness, common design practices. A full explanation is way beyond this article. For now, I'm going to oversimplify this with a few general rules. Rule number one, stresses will flow towards and concentrate around stiffer, strong structures. If you build a large, strong I-beam, it's going to actually attract more stress to it. Rule number two, strength requires thicker structures. More material means more strength, lower stresses. But remember rule number one, more material means more stiffness and more stress attracted to it. And then rule number three, the same structure will exhibit different stiffness depending on the direction that loads are applied. So if we've got that I-beam, we have to think about all the different ways that stresses could be applied to it. And that last point is critical. That's a real tough one. The images on your screen show deflection for the same structure loaded with the same force, just in different directions. That's all I did is I just changed the direction of the force. Now, the deflection plots were exaggerated to show the shape of the deflection, but the color map is matched to the same scale for all of the different images. And I noticed that the out-of-plane force exhibits far more deflection. It's huge compared to the rest. More deflection means lower stiffness. That creates problems when we're thinking about interactions with the complex structure of a ship hull. Multiple structures intersect each other, deflecting in different ways, meeting at right angles, where one might be strong and the other might be weak. Ideally, we want to create a foundation where every structure has the same stiffness at each intersection. Practically speaking, that never happens. All of these physics coalesce into guidelines for foundation design. And most of the guidelines contradict each other.
The code is more what you'd call guidelines than actual rules.
Yeah, that's where the experience comes in. The pursuit of a perfect foundation, that's an eternal quest. It's guided by science, but combining all of the sciences is more of an art. I'll level with you. I don't think anyone ever created a perfect foundation. But the pursuit of perfection still produces major improvements. The following three examples show how I started with a typical foundation and then attempted two new arrangements to improve that design. We are doing optimization. And what does optimization get you? Well, in these examples, it ended up with a foundation that was ultimately 19% lighter, saving approximately $60,000 in fabrication costs. That's a worthy investment. Now, one caveat, these foundations were created for demonstration only. I only showed one load case with each foundation, and keen observers may notice that sections of the foundation were overloaded. A true foundation for contracted engineering receives further refinement, investigation of multiple load conditions, and a larger, more detailed FEA model. Any foundation design begins with picking the right location. Someplace with ship structure that's already oriented for good stiffness in the vertical direction. With our barge, the only thing that qualified were vertical bulkheads that were subdividing the interior. And when we're talking on the level of a large crane, bulkheads are the things that we want to look for. The crane pedestal was put in a good location. It sat on the intersection of two vertical bulkheads, an ideal start for the design. Then we added in some extra transverse bulkheads and two new side longitudinal bulkheads. The intent was to partially support the pedestal with these side bulkheads and pull the loads out into the sides. Let's see if it worked. Well, the stress patterns show a different story. The center bulkhead took most of the load, with little action on the side bulkheads. The critical stresses also showed a sharp peak just as the pedestal entered the main deck. Many parts of this structure were vastly underutilized, and the side longitudinals did little to distribute the loads from the crane. So you have a good start here, but there's a lot of room for improvement. Foundation number two tried to address the different orientations of the crane loads by first transitioning from a circular pedestal to a larger box structure surrounding the pedestal. Four bulkheads were attached to the pedestal, dividing it into four different quarters. Within each quarter, a deck beam also attached to the pedestal, reinforced with brackets above and below the deck. This heavy reinforcement tried to match the stiffness of the bulkheads. The arrangement created eight strong points holding that pedestal, equally spaced to divide the stresses and carry them into the surrounding box structure. This box structure then became the stiff point, which would distribute the stresses to the rest of the ship. But if you see, it's not a simple box. The geometry also tried to reduce weight. Foundation 1 showed little stresses in the side bulkheads. So to reduce the weight, we're putting large cutouts in these bulkheads, with reinforcing beams at the top and the bottom, where most of the action is happening. We also addressed the stress spikes at the main deck by adding brackets above the deck. Brackets create a transition between the flexibility of the pedestal and the sudden stiffness of the main deck. Transitions are a key element to reduce stress spikes. So did it work? Well, the figure on your left side shows the stress distribution, and the figure on the right side shows the critical regions that exceeded the material limits. The side bulkheads showed better utilization this time, shown with higher stresses, and the angled beams did carry some of the load. But that centerline bulkhead still took most of the load. We're on the right path, but not there yet. The cutouts in the side bulkheads may have reduced weight, but we added much of that weight back in by putting that reinforcing collar around each cutout. The total weight reduction was minimal. We saw some improvements, but no significant change to recommend Foundation 2 over Foundation number 1. Let's do better. In our last two attempts, we saw that our main problem was the centerline bulkhead. Stresses from that pedestal were already concentrated near the centerline bulkhead, at least for this load case. That single centerline bulkhead creates a natural flow path. All the stresses want to go there. Except we're trying to disperse the stresses, not concentrate them. The figure on your screen shows one possible solution. All four bulkheads split before attaching to the pedestal. These split bulkheads presented approximately the same stiffness at all eight points of contact, encouraging the loads from the pedestal to divide and distribute. Once in the bulkheads, we added some extra reinforcements to redirect those loads into the deck and the bottom shell. Now, this design was a bit more radical. Did it work? I would say yes. The stress patterns are now a more even loading along the bulkheads. The critical stresses in the figure are only a few tiny hot spots, and the reinforcements successfully redirected loads into the deck and the bottom shell. Due to this better stress distribution, I could reduce the scantlings for most of the bulkhead plating. Lower scantlings saves weight, saves money. Overall, this is a major improvement. And if you look carefully at the picture, some of you might notice that the foundation also tried varying the thickness of the pedestal, creating strong legs that naturally direct the stresses towards the bulkhead interface. That idea didn't really work, owing to the balance between stress and stiffness. Any pedestal change thin enough to redirect the loads was also too thin to carry the stress. No design is perfect, and we learn something new each time. That's gotta be my theme for this whole presentation. No foundation is perfect. Each design reveals new insight and new opportunities for further improvement. That's the art of foundation design, balancing strength and stiffness. It takes creativity to look past the computer printouts to see potential stress patterns and experiment with different solutions. And creativity pays off with better efficiency, lighter structures, and lower fabrication costs. Not quite perfect, but always one step closer, and you can benefit from that improvement. Thanks very much. I am Nick, the Naval Architect. Wait, don't go away. Keep listening to the sales pitch, and you can tell your boss that you're doing business research. And when you talk to DMS, ship design is business. We are here to redefine how you use your ship, changing it from an expensive cost item to an asset that helps you achieve your business objectives. Let's focus on making this a performance-based tool and find engineering solutions to increase your profit margin. If you want to learn more about how we can help you out with those solutions, give us a call. Thanks very much.